ABS-CBN Corporation announces the sale of its interest in Sky Cable to PLDT will no longer push through. In a disclosure to the stock exchange, ABS-CBN Corporation said it has been mutually decided by both parties not to proceed with the sale under the agreement signed by and among the parties in March 2023. Sky Cable now assuring its subscribers they can maintain their subscriptions. It also says Sky's internet broadband service, Sky Fiber, remains unaffected. More corporate stories now. Philippine telecommunications giant PLDT has agreed to pay $3 million in settlement in relation to the expenditure overrun suit filed in California. PLDT is accused of delaying a capital expenditure overrun of over $870 million, resulting in the largest stock drop for the company's American depositary shares in over three decades. Now, in a disclosure to the stock exchange, the company said the proposed settlement agreement does not entail any admission of liability, fault, or wrongdoing by any defendant. If approved by the court, the settlement will fully resolve the U.S. class action against all defendants. The country's second largest bank, Metro Bank, posting record earnings of 42.2 billion pesos for the full year of 2023. That is up 29% year on year. The bank points to asset expansion, higher margins, improving efficiency levels, and better asset quality for the increase. The lender adds net interest income surged by 22.7% on the back of higher loan demand. Gross loans, meanwhile, grew 7.6%, driven by the 15.9% growth of consumer loans. Dominion Holdings, formerly BDO Leasing and Finance, nearly quadrupled earnings in 2023. That is to 277 million pesos. Its gross income, meanwhile, more than doubled to 345 million due to the rebalancing of its investment portfolio towards higher yielding placements and debt securities. The Philippine Energy Department, meanwhile, warns Filipinos of possible power interruptions amid the El Nino. According to the agency, the country's power grid can supply enough electricity to withstand peak demand of nearly 14,000 megawatts. But problems with transmission systems could trigger power interruptions. The DOE is hoping to complete several transmission projects in the Visayas and Mindanao to support hydropower facilities in Luzon amid the weather event.
Ang sanhi po ng outages natin o yung mga nagagiging sanhi ng brownout or blackout ay hindi lang po yung kakulangan ng supply ng kuryente, kundi dahil na rin po kuminsan sa condition po ng ating transmission facilities at maging yung po sa distribution level. Tayo po ay continuous na nakikipag-coordinate sa lahat po natin na power stakeholders kung saan po ay pinapaalala natin mula po sa ating mga generating facilities. Dapat po yung kanilang mga preventive maintenance sa program ay naaayon doon sa tinatawag nating Grid Operating Management Program kung saan naka-schedule po ang mga panahon ng kanilang pagpagdak ng preventive maintenance.
Speaking of the auto industry, the Philippine government urged to speed up the creation of more infrastructure for electric vehicles. For more on this story, let's bring in our correspondent, Jackie Pascual. Hi, Jackie. Go ahead.
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. The Electric Vehicle Association of the Philippines admits that there are still several challenges in beefing up the electric vehicle industry or EV usage in the country. But the group remains optimistic that EV will begin to penetrate the mainstream market in a few years' time. At a media briefing for the Auto Parts and Vehicles Expo 2024, EBAP President or EBAP Assistant Executive Director Neil Lopez said there are still obstacles amid the tax incentives given to EV users. One barrier, he said, is financing, since some banks are still reviewing their loan program for EVs. Some EVs are also still a bit expensive for some users. The Department of Energy said that under the comprehensive roadmap for the electric vehicle industry, the target EVs by 2028 is over 2.4 million units. Now, the number of vehicles as of 2022 is just less than 10,000. EV charging station, Stanley, the target by 2028 is 66,500. Now, there are only 300 plus charging stations. So EVAP said that there is really a big challenge for them to increase the usage of EVs in the country, but they remain confident that they will reach the targets as soon as demand will rise in the coming months and years. EVAP added that more incentives for the EV industry other than tax breaks can be beneficial to the sector, but admitted too that that may not be possible, especially if the government will give subsidies, and that might not be possible right now because of the because other countries give subsidies to EV users, but it might be it might not happen in the Philippines. The Philippine Automotive Traders Association Inc., meanwhile, said that they're actually a bit worried of the rise of EV. Its Secretary General Augustus Chua said that EVs need to be studied more carefully since there are safety issues, but he admitted that the sector might be moving towards that direction. And the groups and the different officials here at the PressCon also mentioned that there needs to help to beef up the infrastructure and other aspects of the EV industry. Sunny, the Auto Parts and Vehicles Expo 2024 will discuss that issue and more. And they had a press conference earlier for their event, which will happen in June this year. And that's the latest. Back to you, Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Jackie Pascual.